There. There, you have me quite out of breath, my dears. I must rest a moment.
When we find Mother, she'll pay you for these lovely playthings.
There's nothing to pay. I give them to you.
Oh, you can't afford that.
Afford it? I'm the world's master toy maker. And I've enough toys stored away to make every child alive happy.
Perhaps Mother wouldn't like it.
Keep those trifles to help you remember me. For a little remembrance in the heart of a child is more to me than anything else in the world.
Haven't you any little boys and girls of your own?
No. That's why I'm free to love all children and to try and make them love me.
Do you make toys that talk?
I talk and walk and do everything but think. I can give them everything but a soul. And someday I may even give them that. But I must go. I have work to do. You come to my workshop and take your choice of the toys there.
Ah, ha, ha! You're the kingpin of all the toy makers, I've heard. I'd like to hire you to make a few toys for me.
Ah, then you love the children too.
Oh, I simply dote on them.
What would you like me to make for them?
A lot of dangerous toys. Toys that a child would eagerly accept. That would cripple them. And even kill them in some clever way.
Why do you hate the children so bitterly?
My late sister left me hers to look after. Two little fiends, a boy and a girl named Alan and Jane, vicious, bad-tempered. What a life they have led me! Even their great fortune, which by law will be mine in another week, will hardly repay me for the trouble they have caused me.
Dead?
Yes. Lost in the forest. In my country, long ago, I've seen the last of them. Thank heaven. £200, if you'll take the order.
Sure.
£400.
Mm?
£500.
No. No.
£800.
£800 for toys that wound and maim. Nothing shall convince me that I've heard correctly.
Clever old fox. He wants more money. I'll see him alone at his workshop and close the bargain before I leave it.